Hello and welcome to yet another video on Standard 6 English, the Honeysuckle book. In this video, we are going to look at the third chapter, which is called Taro's Reward. Now, this story is a Japanese story which has been retold. So, we will look at this chapter in two parts. So, let us begin with the first part. About the story. So, this story is a lesson which gives us an idea of Asian values. Now, children, at the very beginning, I said that this was a Japanese story. So, Japan, it comes under Asia. And through this story, the story of Taro's Reward, we get to know about various values, various points, various qualities which are very much important in this part of the world. There is also a hint of magic in this story. Now, children, what is magic? I am sure you all must have heard about magic. Magic is something which we do not understand with our own senses. It is beyond our understanding. So let us see how the author combines the Asian values along with magic in this story, Taro's Reward. Let us begin the story. A young woodcutter named Taro lived with his mother and father on a lonely hillside. All day long, he chopped wood in the forest. Though he worked very hard, he earned very little money. This made him sad, for he was a thoughtful son and wanted to give his old parents everything they needed. So, Taro was a young woodcutter. A woodcutter is one who chops woods. So, he used to live with his parents on a lonely hillside and he used to chop woods in the forest. Now, all day Taro used to chop wood and he worked very hard. He was a very, very hard working person. But even if he worked hard, he could not earn a lot of money. And this made him very sad. He was very, very upset. Why? Because Taro wanted to fulfill all his parents' wishes. All whatever his parents wanted. He wanted to give his parents everything that they wanted. But since he earned very little money from chopping woods, he could not fulfill all their wishes. That is why it made him very sad. One evening, when Taro and his parents were sitting in a corner of their hut, a strong wind began to blow. So, one evening when Taro and his parents, they were sitting in their house, in their home, in a corner. They live in a village, right? So they are not very wealthy and that is why they do not have a very big house, but it's a small hut. A very strong wind began to blow. It was almost like a stormy sort of a weather condition. It whistled through the cracks of the hut and everyone felt very cold. So since the hut was made of wooden panels and it was totally not air proof, you know, air leaked in through it, and since the weather was really cold, the air which got into their hut, it made them shiver. They began to feel very, very cold. Okay, so it whistled through the cracks of the hut. That is, it made a strong, high-pitched whistling noise while entering the hut and everyone felt very cold. So suddenly, Taro's father said, "I wish I had a cup of sake. It would warm me and do my old heart good." So children, sake is a sort of a Japanese drink. It's almost like alcohol and once you drink it, it makes you very warm. So in cold countries, they drink such liquids to keep themselves warm. and these drinks are usually expensive. So Taro, since he used to chop woods and earn not enough money, he could not afford to get sake. But his father, he was feeling very cold. Usually, naturally he was old, and secondly, the cold wind was blowing. That is why he wanted to have sake. But Taro could not provide him sake. So that is why the old man wished that he had a cup of sake so that it would warm himself down and it would make his old heart good. That is, it would give him some sort of energy. This made Taro sadder than ever, for the heartwarming drink called sake was very expensive. How do I earn more money? He asked himself. So remember, Taro was a very thoughtful son. He wanted to give everything whatever his parents wanted. So when his father wished for a cup of sake, he felt sadder because sake was very expensive. And even after doing so much hard work, chopping so much of woods in the forest, Taro could not earn enough money to survive. And buying such expensive drinks as sake was beyond his imagination. It was like a dream. So that is why Taro was very, very sad, and he asked himself that, how do I earn more money? How will I make more money? How do I get a little sake for my poor old father? He decided to work harder than before. So Taro was such a good son to his parents. He wanted to fulfill his father's wish. That is why he decided to work even harder than before. Next morning, Taro jumped out of his bed earlier than usual and made his way to the forest. He chopped and cut as the sun climbed, and soon he was so warm that he had to take off his jacket. So Taro decided that he would earn more money, for which he even got up earlier than usual. So the normal time at which he used to get up and go to the forest to chop food, he thought that if I get up early, then I would be able to chop more wood in the extra time that I get up. So he went to the forest, he started chopping, and till the time it was really sunny and the day was, the day passed by, the time passed by, Taro became really tired, and he also felt very, very warm from working in the forest. His mouth was dry and his face was wet with sweat. So obviously, doing such a hard work as chopping wood will definitely make you tired. And Taro was also tired, and he was feeling very, very thirsty, and his face was wet with sweat. So he was sweating and perspirating. Okay. My poor old father, he thought, if only he was as warm as I. So Taro is all the time thinking about his father, who was shivering in the cold in the hut, and he just wanted a little sake to warm him. So Taro was thinking that, just as warm as I am right now, I wish even my father felt warm enough so that it did not make him uncomfortable. And with that, he began to chop even faster, thinking of the extra money he must earn to buy the sake to warm the old man's bones. So the thought of fulfilling his father's wish gave him more energy, gave him more motivation, and he started chopping the woods even faster. And all the time, what he thought was earning those little extra money so that he would be able to buy sake for his old father. Then suddenly Taro stopped chopping. What was that sound he heard? Could it be possibly rushing water? Now remember, Taro was really thirsty. So that is why suddenly, while chopping the wood, Taro heard of water noise, as if water was falling from somewhere and it was making a noise. So Taro wondered what that sound could be. Taro could not remember ever seeing or hearing a rushing stream in that part of the forest. So children, as we have seen, that Taro used to chop woods since a long time, and before he had never heard any noise of any such rushing stream or water body where there could be water. But suddenly that day, when Taro had gone to chop the extra wood to earn the extra money, he suddenly heard that noise. So he was thirsty from doing so much of hard work. The axe dropped out of his hands and he ran in the direction of the sound. So obviously Taro did not have water with himself, so he was very, very thirsty, and that is why at hearing the sound of the rushing water, almost like that of a waterfall, he ran to drink water and to ease out his thirst, to satisfy his thirst. Taro saw a beautiful little waterfall hidden behind a rock. So to Taro's surprise, there was a waterfall which was hidden behind a rock. Okay. Kneeling at a place where the water flowed quietly, he cupped a little in his hands and put it to his lips. So you can see in the picture what Taro is doing. See, Taro has a bottle sort of a thing. It's called a pitcher. Okay, where you can store any liquid. And as soon as Taro sees the water body, he goes near it and he holds his two hands together like a cup, and he collects the water from that waterfall, from that fountain, and he holds it to his lips, meaning he drinks it, he tastes it. Was it water or was it sake? He tasted it again and again, and always it was the delicious sake instead of cold water. So suddenly, out of nowhere in the forest, appeared a waterfall which did not give cold water, but it gave sake. Now remember, sake was that same expensive drink which Taro could not afford to buy. Taro could not buy it because it was very, very costly, and Taro did not have enough money from chopping woods in the forest to buy sake for his old father. But now, as he went to the forest and saw the waterfall and he tasted the water from the waterfall, he found to his surprise that it was not water, but it was that delicious, expensive sake which he wanted to give to his father. Taro quickly filled the pitcher he had with him and hurried home. The old man was delighted with the sake. So obviously, Taro's father always wanted some sake, and when Taro brought the sake to him, he was delighted. He was extremely happy. After one swallow of the liquid, he stopped shivering. So the sake immediately made the old man warm. It stopped him from shivering. And the old man, what did he do? In happiness, in extreme delight, he did a little dance in the middle of the floor. So children, you know that whenever we are very happy, we clap our hands and we jump and we dance in happiness. So similar was the case with Taro's father. His father was not expecting that Taro would get him sake, because sake was very expensive, very costly. So when Taro finally brings him a bottle of sake, he is surprised, he is extremely happy, and to show his happiness, he did a little dance in the middle of the floor in his home. That afternoon, a neighbor stopped by for a visit. Taro's father politely offered her a cup of the sake. The lady drank it greedily and thanked the old man. So there was this neighbor who had come to visit Taro's father and his family in the afternoon, and when the old when the lady had come, she was offered some sake by Taro's father. So the sake was really tasty, and the lady drank it greedily. Greedily meaning she drank it with a lot of greed. She wanted it more. Okay, a little cup could not satisfy her. So she had an excessive desire for that drink, and she wanted to drink it more and more. But obviously, she is a guest, she cannot ask more. So that is why she thanked the old man after drinking. And then Taro told her the story of the magic waterfall. So obviously, children, this is the element of magic in the story. That waterfall, it was not there, but it appeared out of nowhere in the forest, and it gave out sake instead of water. So thanking them for the delicious drink, she left in a hurry. By nightfall, she had spread the story throughout the whole village. So this lady, after hearing the story from Taro, she spread the news, and the entire village came to know about that magic waterfall which was there in the forest. So we stop here, and in the next video we shall see what happens next in the story. Until then, bye.